Hey, what's up, everybody? Part of the programming on Patreon, the uploaded content each week. The Lost Zane recordings, two full radio shows a week, Mondays and Fridays. I post those from the old BBL days. Long live BBL. We had a great time there, and I like reliving those moments by having these shows for you in the order that we put them out. As the kids say back in the day, the kids don't say that. Old people say that. Anyway, it's part of Patreon, patreon.com/Eric Zane. With the 10 plus hours of programming, I put it on the free podcast plus the 15 plus on the Patreon. That's a lot each week for you to check out so you're not bored at work or driving or whatever the heck it is. Patreon.com/Eric Zane. I suggest just trying it out for 1 month. See if you like it. $5 a month is all the audio. $10 a month, audio, video, live streams. You got the Patreon bonus podcast each day of the work week, Lost Zane recordings, the Insane Asylum, not to mention Smarter Than a Former Drug Dealer Trivia, and the Ben and Eric Patreon podcast, which a lot of people say is the crown jewel. And I don't blame them because it's a whole lot of fun. Patreon.com/Eric Zane if you want to try it out for just 1 month. If you like it, you can let it ride month to month. Or convert it to a yearly, and I'll knock 10% off of the price. Patreon.com/Eric Zane. Enjoy the free view of the Lost Zane recordings.
Here we go. Thursday, February 2nd, 2017. Welcome into the Eric Zane Show, show number 202. I should say podcast number 202. I think actually more people listen to the podcast than the show itself, frankly. So we might as well just start catering to them.
We're just a glorified podcast. We're a podcast that happens to be on the radio.
Just it gets easier to publish a podcast if we take care of this pesky radio show first. And then we can get to the real meat.
And potatoes.
Yeah, the meat and potatoes. Eric Zane Show question of the day. Whose New Year's resolution has already fallen apart? You know, there's a bunch of people that are like, oh, boy. Well, all right, I'm going to start my New Year's resolution now at the end of February. Because, by the way, hello, Julius.
Hello.
Ben, good morning. How are you, buddy?
I'm good.
I was reading that today is the day, apparently, that statistically, New Year's resolutions completely come unraveled. Leading up to this day, you were kind of like, You know, the first week, you were at the gym for 6 days straight. And you're like,
just grinding away.
Just awesome, man. Hey, I put in 4 hours today. Then it slowly dwindled down, and then you finally missed a day in week number three.
I'll get back on the horse tomorrow.
And then you just have a complete meltdown week four. Oh, I've been super busy. It's okay. I've got those 3 or 4 weeks built up. And then you get to this week, this exact day, and you just say, forget it. I'm not going to try again until next year. 800-785-1073. Eric Zane Show question of the day. Whose New Year's resolution has already fallen apart? Give us the details. It could be about anything that, you know, I don't even know. It could be about whatever your resolution is.
I heard a stat that 48% of people, of Americans, make a New Year's resolution. That seemed high. Is that true? Does that sound right? Make one?
I didn't commit to it.
Oh, jeez. So
I talked about it on the air. It was about reading, wanting to read more. Instead, I've watched more shows. Watching TV is just so much easier. But I have to admit, you know, reading is whenever I read, I like it if it's something I'm interested in. But no, mine never got off the ground. Ben, I don't remember. Did you have one?
No, I didn't.
You didn't have one, did you?
No.
800-785-1073 for whose New Year's resolution has already fallen apart. Give us the details. Eric@ericzaneshow.com for email. You can also follow us on Twitter at Eric Zane Show or at Easy Show OJ or at Easy Show Ben. Ben, what's the update on followers to you at Easy Show Ben? Is it, I think you're gaining like
242.
That's growing much faster than it was before.
Yeah, I guess.
His followers were in line with the show numbers for a bit there.
Yeah, yeah. I saw there was two amazing things we need to talk about from the Drive game last night. First off, it was, it's Darren Hilliard for the Detroit Pistons. And he was one of several players that were playing for the Drive last night. You had Michael Benajay, Darren Hilliard, and
Ellinson?
Henry Ellinson, which he is part of the other story I have for you. But this first one was this guy, Darren Hilliard. Now, I don't know anything about these about Hilliard. They said, hey, he's a Piston. He's going to be playing a lot tonight. They really want to see him get some action. So he started the game. Game starts. 1 second in. They pass him the ball. He drains a three. Okay, cool. That's great. The Westchester Knicks shoot, miss. We get the ball right back. Get it to Hilliard. Three-pointer. Boom. Count it. Fans are like, yeah, this is awesome. He nailed his first six shots, which were all three-pointers.
Oh, wow.
He had 18 points in 4 minutes and 8 seconds.
That's nutty. I saw he had 29 points, I think.
He finished the game. Okay, so, and it was crazy because after the second one, then the Knicks are like, okay, we got to put this fire out fast. But he got open again. And he put it up, and it was in again. And then the fourth one was one of those ones. There was like a guy right in his face, and it was off balance, and it rattled around the rim, but it went in. So that's four. And then on five, he was double covered, and he buried.
Really?
And I'm like, I mean, and the 3,000 people that are there are just so loud. People are losing their mind. And then there was one of the Drive missed a shot, and then his next time down. So he made the first five. The first Drive shots taken were his, and they were all drained. And then the sixth shot that he took was also a three-pointer, buried it, and then Westchester said, all right, timeout. All right,
it took him that long to call a timeout?
Because they were doing okay. I think it was like 15-8 when he put up that sixth one and buried it, and they say, okay, that's it, enough, time freaking out. And that worked. He cooled down a bit. He only made one more, but I think the record is 9 in a game. The fact that he had 4 minutes and 8 seconds in the game, he could have
had like 60 points.
Well, can you, yeah, if he would, he was on a pace to hit like 33 pointers, which would have been 90 points in the game. Just remarkable when you have that hot hand, how everything goes in. I've never seen anything like it. No one there has, because the spotter next to me, Sean, he's been doing this for like 20 years. He's been around basketball his whole life. Okay. Because I've never seen that in my entire life, ever, at any level. 6 3-pointers in a row. To have 18 points, and people are still in line for hot dogs and beer.
They're like, what the hell happened?
And then at halftime, there was a timeout, and one of the refs come over and go, can you believe that? He goes, what? I go, how many he sank? And this shows you how much the refs really don't pay attention to who's shooting. He goes, what are you talking about? I go, Hilliard made 6 3-pointers in a row. He goes,
he did?
He made all those? I go, yeah. I go, well, the first 5 shots taken were his, and he buried them all. And he made 6 in a row, and the ref goes, damn, holy crap. And then so the refs are blown away. No one, and then I'm walking, I see two people I know at halftime. I go, did you see Hilliard? What do you mean?
Nobody saw it.
No one realized it was the same guy. I'm like, are you guys watching what I'm watching? It's number 25. That was all the same guy? No, actually, there was a dude from their team who was also hot, but not nearly as hot as that. I go, can you believe all those threes? And he goes, yeah, so-and-so from Westchester was super hot. I go, no. I'm talking about Hilliard, man. So that was just incredible. Couldn't believe it.
He's a good player. He's kind of what the Pistons have been missing, a three-point shooter. Hopefully he actually gets playing time.
There was something else that happened in the game that I'm going to tell you about the next segment. It was another Eric Zane Show, extremely embarrassing moment. I embarrassed myself badly at the Drive game. And here we are, February 4th will be 1 year from when the fateful night when I dogged Joel, and then that put into motion all the things to get me here where I'm at right now, counting my podcast numbers.
And I desperately want to guess this.
I know you do. I know you do, but don't, please. Coming up in the next segment, I'm gonna tell you how I embarrassed myself badly before the game even started. Unreal. And we have a new game today that I'm super excited about. Ben, you may have seen it on the show plan. It's dotted all over it to tease the game called Bet on Ben. This is a Julius brainchild, and it might be that one of the most fun-sounding radio games I've ever heard. And Ben, you are front stage, front and center on this game.
Yeah, that makes me nervous.
I bet it does.
Makes all of us nervous.
Absolutely. And this game will give the audience a chance to win. We just talked about basketball. We just had fall in our lap four terrific courtside seats from the Meyer Team Gear Department for the Pistons.
Nice.
I don't know. I'm not sure which game it is exactly, but Julius is looking that up right now. We have four terrific seats from the Meyer Team Gear Department.
Yeah, courtside.
Just awesome. If you've seen a game courtside, is incredible. You will love this. So we will play a game where five of you get on the phone, and we're going to play this game coming up at 7:30. So make sure if this is something you want to win, you're listening then when we give you the cue to call. And then we'll line five of you up, and you'll play Bet on Ben. Now, you have no idea how to play this game. In the next segment, I'm going to tell you how we're playing the game, and then I'm going to tell you this embarrassing, awful thing that happened to me at the Drive game last night. We'll get to all that. A lot of fun things in store for you as we do it all this morning on show number two, podcast number 202. And if anyone asks you who you listen to today, please tell them the Eric Zane Show on 107.3 WBBL.
When you shop at a Walmart Vision Center, you get it. You know that you'll spend a little less on stylish glasses for the whole family.
Welcome to the Vision Center. Let me know if you need help finding the perfect frame.
Hey, Mom, you were right. These glasses are cool.
Hon, they take our insurance. That means Papa's getting a new pair, too.
Whoa, glasses start at just $39. Next stop, groceries.
So you can get a little more of what you need. Find a Vision Center near you. Save money, live better. Walmart.
West Michigan. To reach the Eric Zane Show, call 800-785-1073. Twitter at Eric Zane Show.
Eric Zane Show question of the day. Whose New Year's resolution is already falling apart? Tell us how it went, how it disintegrated. 800-785-1073. Eric Zane Show question of the day. How has your New Year's resolution already fallen apart? You can also email them in, eric@ericzaneshow.com. Weather today, it's only going to get up to 19. Did you see that? Or is that a high today, like overnight low?
I didn't see anything about it. Swear,
very cold.
Yeah, 19 is the high today.
19 the high today.
Oh, I was wondering why my nose hairs were like wrinkling up.
Mm-hmm. So you can expect that. We'll keep you updated on traffic too as the morning progresses. So Ben, I talked to you. We teased that coming up at 7:30, we'll be giving the audience a chance to win a 4-pack of Pistons tickets with parking pass. Throwing that in too from the Meyer Team Gear Department. It's a game that we're going to call Bet on Ben. Now, being that the Super Bowl is right around the corner, the way we're going to do this is, Julius came up with this entire idea. You get five audience members on the phone. And then the Bet on Ben part is, and this time it'll be Super Bowl trivia is what we decided to do. And we will ask a question, a Super Bowl trivia question. And then we turn to caller number one and say, now, so-and-so, are you going to bet on Ben or against Ben? Correct?
Correct, yep.
And then he says, okay, I'm going to bet on Ben. And then he's going to hope that you answer that question correctly.
Okay.
If you get it wrong, we hang up on that guy. That's it. He's out. It's a knockout round. If you get it correct after he's bet on you, he lives for another day. And then we go to the next person. And we continue to do that until they're all gone. Last man standing gets the tickets.
Nice.
So we can do this for just about anything, too.
I'm really looking forward to it. That's my revolutionized gaming.
I would like to pencil this in for about 5 years. Because there's a lot of things at work here. First of all, the competition is good. Second of all, the prize is good. Third, it allows Ben to be on the radio to think. And that to me, that is... And it's number three, but to me, it's the top one. It's my favorite thing. So we will play Bet on Ben at 7:30 for a four-pack of terrific seats for the Pistons. Well, I'm sorry. What the hell game is it again? Oh, you told
it's, me. It's the Philadelphia 76ers on... Well, they didn't put the date.
Well, we'll check that out and let you know. I'm sure it's right around the corner with a parking pass. So speaking of basketball, it was first...
Monday, actually.
Monday, okay. So you can plan on Monday when you call. Make sure that if you have Monday free, because that's the tickets you're going to win. I walked into the Deltaplex yesterday for the game. It's been a while since we've done a game because of the weird schedule thing. Drive hadn't been back to the Deltaplex in a month. So walk in. All right, let's do this. And I go walking up over to the drive bench area, and there's a few players that are on the court just kind of working on some shots and things like that, but it isn't a full-on warm-up. It's that early.
Mm-hmm. Shoot around, right?
Basically. And Henry Ellenson is standing right there, and he's got like a warm-up on, and I was like, maybe he's not playing because it looked like he was wearing like street clothes. And so I go, hey, Henry Ellenson, how's your time? It's been too long since we've seen you. How are you, buddy? And he looks at me, and he shakes my hand, and he looked annoyed.
Ooh.
And I thought, oh, man, I shouldn't do that. I don't know, maybe he's a little sensitive to, you know.
He probably doesn't want to, like, he probably wants to play for the Pistons, right? I imagine.
Right, but, I mean, maybe he was, like, getting ready for the game. He doesn't like being bothered. You know, like, sometimes a goalie in hockey does. I know, Jared, with Coro, you do not speak to him. I found that out the hard way. Don't say a word to him.
He threw a burrito at your face.
I mean, he'll just look through you. I mean, if you wave to him, he's going to look right at you, but he's not looking at you, if you know what I mean. So I thought, okay, he didn't strike me as, had no idea. But, so then I go and that kind of an awkward interaction. And then I went over to the scorer's table and started doing what I do to get ready. And then I noticed he's walking back and forth behind me. I was like, well, boy, he sure is walking around a lot. And so I see him again. And then I nod. I, even though I told myself, don't acknowledge this guy because he's clearly a handful. And he just doesn't want to talk to you. And so I look at him, and I did it, though. I nodded, and he looked at me like, and I said it again. I go, hey, Henry. And he looked.
Oh, you actually said something?
Yeah.
Oh,
and even though I just told myself, and I go, why do I always do that? Why do I always feel the need?
Like, you could have gotten away with it if you just did the head nod and then remembered and been like, oh, I'm just bumping to the music.
Oh, sure. Easy.
But no, you have to say, hi, Henry.
So hi. He's probably wondering, why is this old gremlin continually acknowledging me?
Why is Gollum talking to me?
I don't want to talk to you. So that kind of settled. he goes to the locker room, and then I noticed rather quickly, though, that he was playing. I thought that he wasn't playing, but he was. And I also noticed... when he came on the court, that the guy I was talking to was not Henry Ellenson. In fact, I looked at Henry Ellenson and I go, that's not the guy I was talking to. How do you forget? I mean, like...
You're
like,
so racist. Do you think all white people look the same?
The fact that he... You know, it's only been a month. And I mean, and this guy that I was talking to is about 6'3", 6'2". Henry Ellenson is almost 7 feet tall and slender and athletic. This guy was any guy.
Was he even a player?
No, he was a ball boy.
I was going to look at the roster to see.
He was an intern. He didn't even a player.
Oh, my God.
He's just a guy who sits and, like, if the player needs, they need new towels, he goes and gets new towels. There's a reason why he was so confused. And then I was like, oh, my gosh, how do you do the things that you do? You are such a moron.
So that is the worst possible thing that I thought could have happened. I thought he was just pissed because you were like, you talked to him.
Well, that to me would have been the worst. That to me would have been the worst. This one wasn't. I mean, I'm glad I didn't. I just confused someone.
Hey, white guy. Hey, Henry.
So after the game, I went up to dude. I go, man, you probably were confused as hell when I was calling you Henry Ellenson. He goes, yeah, I didn't know what was going on.
Should have gone up to him and been like, here's the thing. I have dementia.
Here's the thing, man. I do weird things all the time, and you just happen to be the latest person to interact with a weird Eric moment. I really apologize for that. So the dude was so confused. Oh, my gosh. My wife has done something worse, though, in confusion. We have in fact, my best friend, he's been in here a couple times. He runs a lot of races, bald guy, Jimmy.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so my wife's walking through Meijer, and she sees Jimmy, and she comes up behind him, sneaks up. This is a true story, man. And she pinches him right on the butt.
Oh, boy.
It wasn't Jimmy.
It was just some white
guy.
Just
turns around, and she goes, and actually ran. I mean, ran, like she stole something away.
She should have at least explained.
She should have been arrested.
Yeah, probably.
She sexually assaulted a stranger is what she did.
Some bald guy. Was his dome shiny?
He looked just like Jimmy from the back. And she goes, ooh, there's that tight little butt. There's that tight little 35-year-old butt. I can't wait to dig my fingers into that. Plink. Oh! So these are all things that happen to us. This is why we should have a reality show videotaping the things that happen to this stupid family sometimes. 800-785-1073 for the Eric Zane Show question of the day. Whose New Year's resolution has already fallen apart? Think about it and call the show. 800-785-1073. I know there's some good ones. You can also email the show, eric@ericzaneshow.com. Coming up next, we're going to dip back to yesterday later in the show when we placed that call to Houston and talked to, I think it was Adriana, the lady at the laundromat.
You kept mispronouncing her name.
Yeah, that was terrible.
Hey, what's your name? Adriana. Yeah, now Ariana.
Yeah, doesn't, it's no surprise. We'll do that and also go over the it was National Signing Day yesterday.
Yeah.
And we need to go over the clubhouse leaders for two of the greatest sports names that have ever existed. We'll go over those. These are guys just coming into play college football this next season. And also, there's a big reason, really good reason, why one of the Michigan State recruits did not sign on signing day. Hey, where'd he go? He said he was going to be here. We'll tell you those stories coming up next. And if anyone asks you who you listen to, tell them. The Eric Zane Show on 107.3 WBBL.
That's it. My free view of the lost Zane recordings. Full show, patreon.com/Eric Zane. See ya.